So now that we have seen how the BTB and the BHT work together, let's do a BTB and BHT quiz on that. Suppose we have the following program. This is the address of the instruction. This is the instruction itself. And these are the labels for branches. So what this program is doing is it's moving 100 into R2. It's moving 0 into R1. And then, as long as R1 and R2 are different, it's going to continue here. Once R1 and R2 are the same, it's going to jump to the done label and exit this loop. In the loop, it's adding R1 to R3 to form R4, uses that to load a value from that address, and then adds that R4 to R5, adds 1 to R1, and then unconditionally branches back to this loop. So this is the loop, this is where we exit from the loop, and this is the sort of initialization for the loop. Suppose that we have a branch history table that has only 16 entries and makes perfect predictions about branches. Suppose we also have a BTB with 4 entries, also makes perfect predictions, and as you can see, all instructions are 4 bytes in size, and we know that. So the question for you is, how many times do we access the BHT for each instruction? Right here, how many times we access the BHT with this address, because we are fetching this instruction. Here, how many times we access the BHT with this address, because we are fetching this instruction, and so on. There are 8 instructions here. For each one of them, we need to say how many times we access the BHT.